go. Hello everyone. This is Shay doing a vlog from Antigua and Barbuda. So right now I am driving along a road that goes through the Antiguan rainforest. So, you might be wondering, rightfully so, how I got here. Funny story. So, it was New Year's Eve, and I'm at the bar, and just talking to some guy. Seems pretty cool. And he says, you want to party hard? I said, yeah, I want to party hard. Shay Galley, I party hard. He says, take this. Takes a little vial, pours it into a shot of vodka. And I say, YOLO, right? And I do the shot. So I wake up on a beach 2 days later. I have no idea where I am. Butt naked. Wake up. I say, where the fuck am I? This isn't Montreal. This isn't even Canada. So I said to the first person that I saw, where the hell am I? I said, Antigua. Oh, well, okay then. Well, that's obviously not a true story, but if you believed it, you can count yourselves among the gullible of us. The real story is a lot less sketchy and funny. I got sent down to do a hand carry. An Air Canada aircraft needed some parts and it couldn't take off until they had these parts, or else it would have had a plane full of people bitching and moaning and screaming at them. So what did we do instead of that? They just sent down a person with these 5 little rubber seals like this big that was holding up the entire aircraft. So I took an extra couple days and here I am, renting a car, ripping around Antigua. So I just dropped off 2 local Antiguans. I guess it's a thing around here to hitchhike. So it's happened twice now in the past hour. That I picked up some locals, and instead of them waiting for the bus, which I presume is unreliable and slow and uncomfortable, you just asked some people driving by, and I said, sure, why not? Last night, I had an interesting experience. So I was walking into town. It took me about an hour, because Dad booked me in a place pretty far away from anything even remotely close. So I decided to walk. And by the end of the walk, it was getting dark, and I was getting through some pretty ghetto areas. And I wasn't too bothered. I didn't seem like anyone was sketchy or anything, but my surroundings were getting pretty run down. So I was looking at my phone to make sure I was going the right way into town, because I thought it wise not to take a wrong turn at this point. And then a guy walks up behind me, the local guy in Antigua, and he says, put your phone away. He's like, this is not a good area to have your phone out. I was like, okay. So I put my phone away. He says, you going into St. John's? I'm like, yeah. He says, all right, you can walk with me. So I walk with him. We're going through. He's taking a few shortcuts. It's dark out by now, and there's people everywhere. Like, I was there. I was going through the same area earlier in the day, and there's no one during the day. I couldn't understand it. And everyone comes out at nighttime. I don't know. Don't ask me why. So we're going through, we get into St. John's. I said, hey, you hungry? I was looking for some food. He says, yeah, sure. I said, I want some local Antiguan food. Takes me into this tiny little hole in the wall place. And I get some pretty ratchet looking chicken on top of a pile of rice. And he says, hey, do you want to eat it here or you want to go outside? I said, I don't know, whatever. He says, all right, we can go hang out and eat and chill. I said, okay. So he takes me down a back alley, and there's a bunch of guys, local Antiguan guys, that are all, seem like they're partying, drinking and stuff, getting loud and rowdy. And I think, this might not be a very good situation. Keep in mind, I'm the only white dude in sight. Kind of means you stick out. So, walk down the alley. He just pulls up a chair next to some girl who's had a little shop on a table selling cigarettes and other so miscellaneous items. Says hello. I say hello. We just sit down. We start eating our food. Eating our food, and then people start coming up to him, and he starts pulling out little bags of weed. He's selling them weed. I said, okay. Then he says, where are you from? I say, I'm from Canada. He's like, oh yeah, Canada. Pretty cold up there. I'm like, yeah. I said, you know, winter just gets real cold. Snow. I said, have you ever seen snow? He says, yeah, I have seen snow. I went to Montreal once. I was like, no way. I live in Montreal. He says, yeah. So I've been to Montreal. He was telling me about where he went. I couldn't really understand what he was trying to say about where he went in Montreal, but the point is, he said he went to Montreal before I even mentioned it. Then mentioned, believe it or not, that he had a cousin or a friend or something in Ottawa. Let's look at this view for a sec. So I said, wow, that's hilarious. He says, you want a beer? I said, yeah, sure, I'll have a beer. We go into the bar across the street, which was very rowdy, full of local Antiguans. Only men around too, by the way. I said, all right, I'll walk in this bar. Who cares? I'm with this guy here. He seems like he's a respected fellow. I'm going to go in. I go in. This place is probably a few meters square. It's tiny. And they're like really intensely playing pool. And they're all watching the game. Might add money on it or something. I don't know. But it was just one room with the pool table, surrounded, packed, with guys all watching the pool game going on. We go to the back, and I'm walking through, and every single person looks at me. They are all looking at me, and I don't know, it didn't seem hostile, but the fact is, when you're that draw that much attention, you notice it. It makes you slightly uncomfortable. And I went in and got a beer, and he bought me a beer, and we went back and kept chilling. It was all good. So then after the beer, I said, okay, I think I've had enough local time for now. It's pretty dark, I'm alone. Back to the hotel, so he just waves over his buddy, and his buddy drives him back to the hotel in his piece of shit falling apart little Toyota car. He's blasting his music, and he just ripping it around the roads, driving pretty dangerously, and he drove me back to the hotel. hotel, and I gave him $20 US, and he was enormously thankful. So yeah, that's my first night in Antigua. Today I woke up, said, where do I find a motorcycle? Asked around, made some phone calls, no motorcycles. I haven't even seen a single one on this entire island, actually, so chances are there's not really any to rent. So I got the next best thing, this Suzuki SUV thing. So I drove around today, I've been driving around the island, did some touristy stuff. Went to a tourist site called Nelson's Dock, which is an 18th century harbor, which was very useful for hurricane shelters. And it was mostly tourists from cruise ships. There's a noticeable saturation of elderly white people around. Really seem to be having a good time, but I mean, I don't know, maybe that's just being old. So I did that, went up on the hill, took a few pictures, and now here I am driving through what the map says is a rainforest, although not really so too much forest right now. So far what I've seen from the locals is they're very relaxed, very chill. Things move pretty slowly around here, but I think that's just the Caribbean way. So if you're that kind of person, that's not a bad life. You know, island life, got sunshine and beaches. Drink beers and smoke pot, good to go. Not a bad life. But a little bit limited, I would say. I mean, to be fully honest, I'm getting a little bored with this island. I haven't even been here 24 hours. But I mean, that's just me. I need more than the beach. Want a quiet family vacation, uneventful, then this is the place for you. Not me. Turner's Beach. I was told I should go here.